Good afternoon, everyone. I am Harsha from APSSDC. In today's concept of DBMS, we will learn about delete command. So how to delete the values from the table and how to delete the table as well as how to delete the database. Okay. So in yesterday's concept and day before yesterday's concept, we have discussed about how to create the database and how to get into that particular database and how to create the table and followed by storing the records into that particular table followed by updating the records. Okay. So let us see the update command one more time. As per our yesterday's session, we have updated only one single value. Okay. What if I want to update more than one single value? Okay. So first we will complete about that particular update command, then we will go with the delete operation. Deleting a single record or deleting more than one single record, nothing but multiple records, followed by deleting the table and finally deleting the database. Okay. We will see all these particular things in today's session. Okay. So first of all, let me open SQL Server. Okay. So let me type SQL Server Management Studio, or else you can even type SSMS, which represents SQL Server Management Studio. Okay. Yes. Now once we are opening SQL Server, we know how to connect to this particular SQL Server database. You need to provide the server name and you need to provide the server type, followed by select the respective authentication, provide the username and password. Okay. It's your wish whether you want to remember the password or not. Okay. Yes. Now, once I am done with this particular thing, so let me have our previous content queries. Okay. So we have implemented something like this. Okay. We have created the database and we have created the table. We have stored some data into that particular table, followed by displayed that particular records. Okay. So, creating the demo database, getting into that particular database, and we have created the student table, inserted some records into this particular student table as well as retrieved some records. These are nothing but day 1, and in the day 2 we have added some more records into this particular table in a different scenario. Okay. Rather than inserting in the standard way, so we have selected the respective column and the respective order, in which order the values has to be inserted into the respective table. Then what is happening? We have done some filtrations. I just want to retrieve either all records, or else I can retrieve the selected record. Okay. So first getting into that particular database, and I can retrieve all the records from this particular table, or else I can retrieve only the selected records. The person name is Ravi. Okay. Yes. Now what I'll do, I just want to update more than one single record. Previously what we have done, we are updating the student table and setting the course to Java, where student name equals to Ravi. So what is happening, once I am updating this particular thing, only one single record is getting updated. Only one single record is getting updated. Okay. Nothing but only Java. Now coming back to this, sorry, only one single value is getting updated, nothing but Java. What if I want to update Java as well as student name? Okay. So in that case, how to implement that particular thing, we will see. Okay. So what is happening, we have updated this particular record to Ravi, and let me update this particular record 10, let me make this one as 104. So what is happening now, Kiran course will be getting updated to C language, and Sai Teja course will be getting updated to SQL Server. Okay. So we have couple of records in our table. Okay. These are some of the records. Now what is what I want to do, I just want to update this particular okay, I just want to update this particular record, let me say Ramesh record. Okay. So here what is happening, I just want to change the course as something like a CPP, change the course to CPP, and I just want to change the name from Ramesh to Ramu. Okay, I just want to change the course as CPP from Cobalt to CPP, and I just want to change or update this particular name Ramesh to Ramu. Okay, so let us implement that particular query. Okay, for the record called 102. Okay, so what I'll do, let me write this particular thing. So updating more than one single value. Okay, yes, updating more than one single value. Let me say something like update student set, let me say course equals to my course name, I just want to provide it with C++, comma, and student name is equals to Ramu. If I am executing this particular thing, for all the records, student name will be set to Ramu and course will be set to C++. Okay, then what is happening, in that case I just want to implement filterations where student number is matching with 102. Okay, so what is happening, these particular values course and student name will be set to the respective record whose student number is matching with 102. Let me execute this particular thing. One row is affected. Let me display all the values, all the column values from the student table. So in that case what is happening, let me zoom it. Okay, so this particular record 102, this particular record is modified, nothing but updated. The course value is updated to C++ and the name value is updated to Ramu. Okay, like this I can update more than one single value for a particular record unless I am using the where condition, okay, or where clause. Okay, so if I am not using this particular where clause, what is happening, for the entire table, okay, the student name will be getting set to, for the entire table the student name will be set to Ramu and the course will be set to something like C++. So yesterday we have already seen something like, what if I am updating the student table and setting the course to COBOL. So in that case what is happening, all the values of this particular course column is updated with COBOL, okay, for each and every record. Okay, if I want to update more than one single value of a particular record, so what I need to do, so you just need to set the column value, column name equals to the respective value followed by comma, second column name equals to the respective value. Okay, just you need to separate these particular values by comma and update the respective record. Okay, yes. So let me go with the next one. I just want to delete the data. Just want to delete the data, delete the records, either single record or multiple records from student table. Just want to delete either a single record or multiple records from student table. Okay, so let us delete this particular thing. So we have a command called delete command. Okay, now so delete is used for deleting the data within the table, inside the table or from the table. Delete, what I want to delete, I want to delete student table. So what is happening, student table is getting deleted? No, student table is not getting deleted, the contents of this particular student table is getting deleted, nothing but the contents are nothing but the records of the student table. Okay, all these particular records will be getting deleted. So it is similar to update student and set course equals to COBOL. So what is happening, for all the records of the student table, the course column is updated with COBOL. Similarly, whenever I am saying delete student, so what is happening, as I did not provide any filtration, so what is happening, the entire records of this particular student table will be getting deleted. Now if I want to delete the selected record, what I need to do, so delete student where you can say student number is equals to 102. student number is equals to 102. So in that case, what is happening? It is going to match this particular student number and the respective record is getting deleted. Nothing here. What is happening? The record 102 will be getting deleted. Okay. Yes. So let me execute this particular thing. One row is affected and let me say select star from student. So what is happening? The record 102 is deleted. Suppose this is how we are going to delete the records using student number. What if I want to delete the record using student name and course? Let us see in the next query. So let me say something like delete student, where you can even say student number equals to 103, like this. Okay. Or else I will go with the name, student name is equals to, I just want to delete the record called Kiran. I just want to delete the record called Kiran. So in that case, what I'll do? As Kiran is a group of characters, you just need to enclose them within the single quotation. So select this particular query and execute it. So what is happening? One record is affected. So let me execute this particular query where I'm able to get all the records from the table. So you can see that the record with the Kiran is already deleted. Okay, now. So the now the table contains only 3 records. Now what I'll do? I just want to delete this particular record based on course. I just want to select the course as COBOL. So in that case, you can see that 2 records will be getting deleted based on the course value. So what I'll do? I'll just say something like delete student where course is equals to, let me say COBOL. Course is equals to COBOL. So select this particular thing and execute it. Now you can see it here. What is happening? 2 rows are affected. Now in that case, let me execute this particular student table, display the student table. So what is happening now? Student table contains only one single record. Okay. Yes. Now what I'll do for the better confirmation, I just want to add couple of records where the query is already provided in our earlier session. What I'll do, I'll just copy this particular query 1, 2, 3 and I'll just paste it over here. So what I'll do, I just want to insert for some additional records. So what is happening now? 3 records are added and let me say select star from student. Now what is happening? This particular student table contains 4 records. Forgot about the data is getting repeated. I just re-executed this particular content. No issues. Okay. So what I'll do now, instead of using this particular filtration, so what I'll do, I'll directly provide the command called delete student. Okay. So whenever I'm saying something like delete student, so in that case, what is happening? All the data or all the records from this particular student table is getting deleted. Nothing but what is happening? 4 rows affected. So let me say something like select star from student, we can see that there is no record in this particular table. So what is the advantage of this particular delete? Using delete, okay. So using delete, option number 1, I can delete the selected record or records, the matching records. Option number 2, I can delete all the records from the table. Okay. So either I can delete a single record or multiple records, or else I can delete all the records from this particular table. Now similar to this particular delete, we are having a keyword called truncate. So we will discuss this particular truncate in depth. Now, till time being, the difference between this particular truncate and delete is going to delete all the records and truncate is also going to delete all the records. That is the similarity, and the difference is delete is able to delete either one single record or the selected records. But truncate, I cannot customize that particular command in such a way that to delete a single record or more than one single record. So completely truncate is utilized for deleting all the records from the table. Now as I do not have any records in this particular table, so what I'll do, I'll re-execute this particular query. So where I'll be having 3 records in the student table. So let me say select star from student. Yes, I am having 3 records. So what I'll do, I'll provide this particular truncate command. Just say truncate. So what I want to truncate, I want to truncate the table. So which table? The student table. So what is happening? Let me execute this particular thing. So what is happening? Command completed successfully, and let me say select star from student table. So what is happening? All the records are getting deleted. Okay. So either I can use a delete command for deleting all the records, or else I can use truncate command for deleting all the records. Okay. Truncate is also used to delete all the records from the table. This is similarity between delete and truncate. The dissimilarity or the difference is delete is capable of deleting a single record or the selected records, but truncate I cannot do any selection or I cannot delete one single record. Okay. Yes. Further we will discuss about when we are interacting with identity function, there we will discuss about one more difference related to truncate and delete, where the identity value will not be getting reset using the delete command, but the identity value will be getting reset using the truncate command. That will be the difference practically we will see when we are dealing with identity functions. Okay. So if I want to delete all the records, either I can use delete for time being, or else I can use truncate, okay, for deleting all the records. Okay. For deleting a single record or the selected records, definitely I need to go with delete command only. Okay. Yes. Now, so under the DDL data definition language, we have interacted with only create. So I have created database and I have created table, that's it. We need to interact with something like alter and drop. These are the things. So update or alter, we will discuss this particular thing later when we are dealing with the database concept. So how to create the primary data file or secondary data file, at that particular moment we will go with these particular things, but for the time being, if I want to know how to delete a table and how to delete a database, okay, completely, not the data from that particular table, I just want to delete the table itself, so I need to go with drop. I just want to delete the database, I need to go with drop. Okay. When it comes to the data manipulation language, I think we have completed insert. Okay, we have inserted the records into the table. In the yesterday session we have completed with update, and in today's session we have completed delete. So we have inserted the record into the table, we have updated the data from that particular table, as well as we have deleted the data from the respective table. Okay. So to the alternative to the delete, I can even use something like truncate for the time being in order to delete all the values. Okay. Now, yes. Now when it comes to the DQL, we have completed something like select. So we haven't completed select, we just done some queries related to the select. So what are the operations that I can perform, displaying the values in ascending order or descending order, or followed by searching the records, entire thing, the entire select concept will be continuing from the next session. Okay. Now, yes. So for today's session, let me go with the next one called drop. Okay. So already I have told you in the earlier session something like what are the things I am discussing in yesterday's or today's or day before yesterday's session. These are only the introduction in order to implement what are the operations in the database. Okay. So we will see these particular thing as a step by step concept based on the operations in the database server. So first we will complete entire select, then followed by we will go with a language by language. First DQL, where class, having class, each and everything will be getting completed, then step by step we will go with the next one. Okay. Now let me go with drop operation. Drop. So what is the difference between drop and delete? Delete is used to delete the data from the table. Okay. So if I am having any records in the table, and if I want to delete that particular record, so I can go with delete query. Okay, delete is completely utilized for deleting the data inside the table. Okay, now if I want to delete the table itself, so what I need to do, I need to use drop command. Okay, so if I want to delete the database, so I can use drop command. So I cannot use delete and drop on the table, okay, or a database. Okay, so if I am using delete on database, simply it is going to raise an error. If I am using delete on table, simply the data in the table will be getting deleted, but the table and its structure will not be getting deleted. Okay, so let me use this particular drop command. Let us have the SQL server. So what I'll do, we having the table called student, so let me say select star from student. So what is happening, simply we are getting this particular student table. Let me add a couple of records. Okay, I just want to make sure that I can even delete this particular table even if this particular table consists of couple of records. So I am inserting some of the records. Now this particular table contains 3 records. Now the table contains 3 records. So what I'll do, I'll just use drop command. Drop table, what I want to drop, I just want to drop this particular table, and the table name is student. So what is happening, the student table is getting deleted completely from the database. Command completed successfully. Okay, if you see these particular database commands, it is saying one record updated, it is not saying one record updated or one record modified or affected kind of thing. Simply it is saying command is executed or completed successfully. So let me re-execute this particular student table. So what is happening, simply it is going to raise an error called invalid object name. Okay, simply it is saying invalid object name, as this particular student table is deleted from the database. Okay, now what I want to do, I just want to deleting the student table permanently from the database. Okay, deleting this particular student table permanently from the database. Okay, now what if I want to delete this particular database? So we are in demo database. So what is our database? Our database is something like demo. Okay, now in that case, I just want to delete this particular demo database from the SQL server, from the database server. So what I can do, I can say something like drop. What I want to drop, I want to drop the database. Which database I want to drop? If you remember our previous session, when I have created these particular databases, I have shown you how to create the database of demo as well as demo 1. Now first what I'll do, I'll just drop this particular demo 1 database. So let me implement that particular query. Okay, so let me say drop database demo 1. So right now we are exactly inside this particular demo database, and we are trying to delete this particular demo 1 database. So what is happening? So let me select this particular query, and you can use the shortcut called F5 for executing the query. So what is happening, command is completed successfully where demo 1 database is executed, nothing but deleted from the SQL server. But even though we are able to see this particular demo 1 database, so what we will do means we will just refresh this particular SQL server. So let me say refresh. So after implementing refresh, let me expand this particular databases. So what is happening, there is no demo 1 database. Now what I'll do, I'll try to delete the demo database. So drop database, and the database name is demo, select it and execute it. You can see that simply it is going to raise an error. Why? Because we are already inside this particular demo database. So I cannot delete the existing database, okay, with the database which is under utilization, which is under use. Okay, now first we need to get out of this particular demo database, then you are capable of deleting this thing. So what is the error we are getting? Cannot drop database called demo because it is currently in use. So in that case, what I'll do? First, I'll move to some other databases, any of the database starting from here till here, except demo. Except demo, you can get into any of these particular database which contain this particular drop rule. Okay. So let me get into the AdventureWorks, or it might be a system databases called master. Okay, might be any of these particular things. These are the predefined databases which we will be getting when SQL Server is installed, and these are the databases which I have attached. Okay, now so what I'll do, I'll just get into the master database. So use master. So what is happening, before executing, let me confirm it, we are inside the demo database and execute this particular thing. Now what is happening, now the database is modified to master. Now once the database is modified to master, let me drop the database called demo. So let me say execute it. Yes, command executed successfully. So what is happening, the demo database is deleted from the SQL server. So what I'll do, let me select this particular server and just click on refresh. As I can see this particular demo database, let me refresh this particular server and expand the databases. You can see that there is no demo database. So we have completed this particular drop operation also. So we have done something like create a database DB, and we have created the table. Then what is happening, drop, we have deleted this particular table as well as we have deleted the database. Now when it comes to the these are what, DDL level operations, data definition language. When it comes to DML, we have implemented something like insert, we have implemented update, and we have implemented nothing but delete. These are the queries that we have done using the data manipulation language, and followed by DQL, data query language, we have implemented something like select. Okay, using select operation, I am able to retrieve the records. So using insert, update and delete, you can perform some operation manipulation on table. Okay, then followed by using DDL, you can perform some manipulations on the database server. Either you can create the database, or else you can delete the database, or you can create a table within the database and you can delete the table from that particular database. Okay, yes. Now let me go to the previous content and let me create this particular database one more time, as I want to perform some other operations. So what is happening, so creating the database, getting into that particular database and creating this particular table and inserting couple of records. Okay, so yeah, here we are having inserting couple of records. So right now this particular student table contains 5 records. Okay, yes. Now you can see that here number of languages. Okay, so we are having SQL Server, number of courses selected by the students. It might be SQL Server, it might be Java, it might be C language, C++, and SQL Server. Now what is happening, as an end user, I just want to know that how many courses are available in this particular student table. Okay, so let me update this particular CPP by Java one more time. So update student table, set course is equals to, let me say Java, where student number is equals to 104, then what I'll do, I'll just say select star from student. So what is happening here, 2 courses are repeated, one is SQL Server and second one is Java. Okay, here 2 courses are repeated. Now I just want to get all the available courses from the student table. So what I'll do, select course column from student table. So what is happening, whenever I am saying select course columns, in that case, as 5 students are registered, so what is happening, I am able to get 5 values, where in these the values are repeated. So here what is happening? I am getting the repeated values. Now in these particular things, if I want to identify how many courses are available, so as I am having only 5 values, I can read these particular things directly. So my course is SQL Server, my course is Java, and one more course we are having something like C language. Okay, these are the 3 courses, and remaining courses are repeated, no issues. So I am able to identify 3 courses are there in the student table. Now what is happening, what if this particular student table contains 1000 records, or let me go with very simple, 100 records. So I just want to identify how many courses are there in this particular student table. Okay, so what is happening, each student is getting registered to a particular course, and multiple students might be getting registered to more than one single course, okay, or same course. Okay, now in that case what is happening, these particular course values are repeated. So in order to identify the unique values, it is time taking process. Now in that case we are having a keyword called distinct, we are having a keyword called distinct. Distinct is a keyword which is going to eliminate, what is happening with the distinct, which eliminates the duplicate values, which eliminates the duplicate values. Okay, now so right now within this particular course column, do we have duplicate values? Yes, SQL Server is repeated twice and Java is also repeated twice. I don't want to display 5 values, I just want to eliminate these particular duplicate values. So in that case what I am doing, I can use this particular distinct keyword. Just you can say something like select course from student table. So we can see that the course values are repeated. Now before the course, let me apply this particular distinct keyword. So now let me execute this particular thing. You can see that the duplicate values are eliminated. Okay, now so whenever I just want to do the filtration, or whenever I just want to retrieve the unique records, so I can use this particular keyword called distinct keyword. Okay, now yes. Now before getting into the further concept, with this I am completing with all the basics related to the databases. Okay, now so when it comes to the database, we got to know that how to create a database. Now within the database, how to create the table. Now within the table, how to insert the records, how to update the records, and how to delete the records from that particular table. Now to the alternative to the delete, you can even use truncate for the time being. Okay, now then what is happening, we got to know that how to retrieve non-duplicate records. Okay, now the unique records from this particular table, small keywords and small operations. Okay, now we got to know that how the operations are getting performed using these particular DDL, DML and DQL languages. Okay, now so transaction control language will be getting discussed under transactions, and or else grant and revoke. Okay, now you can even say data control language is also getting discussed in the appropriate session. Okay, now yes, when the users are getting created, how to grant the permissions and how to revoke the permissions, remove the permissions, we will be discussing that particular part. Okay, now so now coming back to the next one, as we know the basics of this particular DBMS. Okay, so I just want to give you a small difference between what exactly it is an SQL, what exactly it is a PLSQL, and what is SQL Server, and what is MySQL, all these particular things. Okay, now so first let me go with the notepad, let me open the notepad. Okay, now let us see the notepad. What are the available database servers we are having? For example, something like SQL Server. Okay, we will see the notepad right now. Okay, so yeah, SQL Server, then followed by Oracle, followed by DB2, followed by Ingress, followed by MS Access. So these are some of the database, something like MySQL. Okay, so these are some of the available database servers. So instead of saying this is not SQL, it is exactly MS SQL, Microsoft SQL. These are database servers. Okay. Yeah. Now all these particular database servers understands a common language. All the database servers understands common language called SQL, representing structured query language. Okay, na SQL. Now using SQL, it is completely query based. It is completely query based. Okay, now you are providing queries. Queries are nothing but something like commands. Okay, now command based, or I can even say actually it is a query based. Okay, for our understanding, I can even say something like it has an command based. So you are just providing a simple command, select star from query, just like copycon mkdir kind of thing. Okay, now so it is a query based. So what is happening? Sometimes I have a requirement that one single query has to be executed for multiple number of times, so that I can use a concept called loops. Similarly, I might be having a requirement in order to store the data in the SQL. So in that case, I might be required a concept called variable. Variable. Okay. So sometimes I might be required to implement conditional execution. Okay, if the user age is greater than or equals to something like 18, so what is happening? He is eligible for applying voter ID or applying driving license, such kind of thing. So I just want to implement conditional execution. So these particular features belongs to programming language. These entire features belongs to programming language. Okay. Or else we have already learned these particular features. Either I can say programming language, or else I can even say procedural or programming language features. Okay, procedural or programming language features. So what they have done, as SQL, nothing but structured query language, doesn't support all these particular things. So these particular features, procedural features, are binded with SQL. So these particular procedural features are binded with SQL, and they have made this particular end product as PLSQL. So what is PLSQL? It is nothing but features from procedural language, features from procedural language are binded to the SQL, structured query language. So we call this particular thing as PLSQL, nothing but procedural language in structured query language, where I can implement loops. Now I cannot perform all the programming operations over here. Okay, so programming operations has to be done through the programming languages. Here what is happening, we are implementing only partial programming, where the query has to be executed for multiple number of times, some functions has to be applied. Okay, code reusability has to be done, nothing but query reusability has to be done. So these particular procedural language features are added, or nothing but binded to the SQL. So we are seeing this particular entire concept as, okay, PLSQL, procedural language in structured query language. Okay, so here SQL is a structured query language which will be identified by all the database servers where the query will be getting executed. PLSQL is also a language, procedural language in SQL, which will be getting identified by all these particular database servers. But what is SQL over here? It is a product name, Microsoft SQL Server. It is a database server. What is MySQL? It is a product name, database server, just like Oracle, DB2, Ingress, and MS Access. Don't get confused. Whenever you are saying SQL, it is a language which will be utilized for implementing operations on database servers. What is PLSQL? procedural language features in SQL in order to perform the operations in database server. Now, what is SQL Server or MS SQL Server? It is a product name. What is MS MySQL? It is also a product name. Okay, now, yes. So, okay. So, these are the things that we have discussed in the today's session. So, what we have done in the today's session? So, we have completed update operation, we have completed delete operation. So, we have updated the data from the table, either it may be a single value or it might be more than one single value. Followed by, I have deleted the data from the table, I have deleted table itself, as well as I have deleted something like database also. Okay, now, we have implemented updating and deleting the data as well as database. Okay, now, data from the table followed by table and the database. Then we have learned how to get the unique values, distinct values from the respective table, as well as we have find out the difference between what exactly it is an SQL, PLSQL and Microsoft SQL Server as well as MySQL. As the term SQL is getting carried in all these particular four names, so some of the students might be getting confused what exactly this particular SQL is. So, SQL is a language which will be getting identified by all the database server used to interact with the databases. Okay, now, yes. And PLSQL is procedural language in SQL in order to implement partial programming features in SQL. Followed by Microsoft SQL Server and MySQL are the vendors or the product names. Okay, yes. So, the rest of the topic, nothing but select and remaining operations in the SQL Server will be continued in the next session. I am Harsha from APSSDC. Thank you.